Xanatos here. It's your doctor with test result.
Hey, Lil. Cool t-shirt. Thanks.
Leedy, the cats will be better fed than we will on this plane.
You're not just saying that to make me feel better, are you?
Now, why would I do that?
Well, what about how can we make sure they can maintain the temperature in the baggage compartment? What if they freeze? I gotta get down and see the cats. I wanna...
Something involving armed mercenaries?
Not to my knowledge. Perhaps it's time to pay Dr. Severius a visit.
Thanks, Francis.
No problemo, pal.
Assemble in the safe room.
That's a go for me.
Than the King of Spain.
Well, speaking of kings, the chief and high priest seem a bit, ten.
Bonsoir, and welcome to the world premiere of Macbeth in Space. Thank you. The part of Macbeth, normally played by Nick Dean, will be played...
I was in such a hurry to finish, but now I'm sorry it's over.
I wish there were more books. I bet that after this story ended, they rode off to have even better adventures.
Yeah, I can imagine all the great adventures they could have.
I can think of 100.
Not so fast.
But you know she's right. Tree sap would be perfect.
Just stay with the ship.
Now hear this. Now hear this. All personnel report to the briefing room ASAP. This is not a drill.
Spacecom has just confirmed that our most advanced surveillance satellite has been blasted out of orbit, somewhere over Antarctica. So far, it's been their game, but starting now, we're taking this battle to Cobra.
Alive? After he, well, he pulled Ursula's scrunchie off. We know that much.
50 zamolis a man, what do you say?
They only speak Swahili.
100 zamolis a man and you got a D.
Hey, wait a second.
Done.
Shut up, Puss! I think I said the truth. Oh, I knew we was lost.
Don't listen to him, Thor. He's just trying to trick us. Lead us off the shortcut so we take twice as long on the regular trail.
We're already taking twice as long.
Are you going to let a monkey make a monkey out of you?
What?
Thank you. Macbeth will be played by Jimmy Neutron.
Woo-hoo! I'm gonna go give Jimbo a few last-minute acting tips before he gets started.
Yeah. He'll be fine, Hugh. After all, he is a genius.
We made it through the day, Momo. And it was pretty fun.
Angry ogre you always be.
And you're still the same annoying donkey.
Yeah.
Well, look out, princess. Here comes the new me.
First things first. We need to get you out of those clothes.
Well, good. Now you're in charge, okay? And if I were you, I'd make sure I had this machine working at full power by tomorrow morning.
About what?
About recess! Quickly! We've only got 4 minutes left!
Quick, to the auditorium! And no running in the halls!
What? Look at that disgraceful beast!
Good Lord, what has become of the sport of...
Give up! You're outnumbered!
That's my third monocle this week. I simply must stop being so horrified.
Puts an evac station up 30 flights of goddamn stairs.
Come on, Coach. Maybe the helicopter. Maybe it's made of chocolate.
This is Principal Prickly speaking. You may have noticed a few changes around your school today, and these are nothing to be concerned about. They're all part of the Board of Education's new school improvement policy. So I hope you'll all enjoy your new improved...
Ow! DJ, what are you doing in my office?
Some bloody idiot spilt his drink. All the other ladders died in the sky and were buried in the sand. Good chaps, every one of them, too.
Oh, hey, Winston.
Yeah. You know, O'Connell, ever since the end of the Great War, there hasn't been a single challenge.
Give me one good reason why I shouldn't rip you apart.
Oh, Simba, you must understand. The pressures of ruling a kingdom.
That's all for now. Just go back to your fun.
All right, TJ, I understand if you're upset.
Important thing, Quaim, is that I was outnumbered. Absolutely.
Equaled only by the great Jack Whittingham.
You said those Argentinian horses like Bayacoa and Passiana and Different and Festine. This one has speed. Bacchanali chose the number one post in the post position draw and told me he thinks Asadero is going to go right to the front.
Chester House is a five-year-old son of Mr. Prospector. He was second to Ladies' Den in the Eddie Reed in his last out.
He was formerly a European, and you see he's still got a little of that European in him with no pony accompanying him in the post-parade. You heard him making noise in the paddock there, according to Charles E., and trainer Bobby Frankel hopes he saves some of that noise for the eighth ball.
Godolphin Racing is represented by Slickly, and this is his first start outside of his native France.
Now, the Arlington Million is part of the Emirates World Series of Racing, as we've said, which is sponsored by Sheikh Mohammed. The big question here, is this the A-horse that the Godolphin has over there right now to bring here, or do they just want to be politically correct and make sure they bring some horse to this race? That's the question handicappers have, but clearly he can run a little.
Mandar has won $650,000 in 13 lifetime starts, including two straight grade ones.
He is an off-the-pace kind of horse, dependent, of course, on some of the early fractions. He'll be mid-pack or so. The question here is the 70-day layoff.
Vienna Motto has won two in a row, including a romp in the Sunset Handicap.
And look how gorgeous this one is. Vienna Motto's grandsire Manila won this race in 1987. So there's a little Arlington Million history in his pedigree there.
The world-traveling running stag is making career start number 40. He has won $1.6 million.
The question here is, he going to be as good on turf as he is on dirt? He's had plenty of turf races, one for 19, as we said. What Phil Mitchell, the trainer, likes to point out is the race in Hong Kong last December, where he was second to a pretty good horse named Jim and Tonic on grass.
And rounding out the field, Mula Gula, four-year-old son of Lily T, who won the Kentucky Derby back in 1992.
Talk about racing luck. His Washington owner, Stephen Gula, had never owned a horse before. Decided to buy this one for $6,000, and Mula Gula now has made a little less than a half million, but is a legitimate long shot in this race.
This is a job for Mona the Vampire, Zapman, and Princess Giant. Charlie, bring your Zaporama loaded with grape juice. Lily, bring your dad's supersonic stapler. You got it!
Sure!
Gentlemen! First, we must plan our strategy.
Yes. According to myth, Valentine's is his busiest day.
Okay, Dad. Thanks for your help.
Personally, I should prefer to see the Aborigines.
That's it! Lead us to him, Fang! Lead us to Cupid!
I shall try to be worthy of my post.
This way, this way!
I've had it! I am the richest, smartest, handsomest guy here, so I have to go...
Excuse me, pardon me. Get it out of the...
Ow!
Well, if you don't want to get stepped on, stay in class. TJ Detweiler, as your principal, I order you to come out of your room right now.
I told you we needed a transfer back at the Renaissance, but no. Come on, we'd better head back to the coach stop.
You got it all wrong!
Hold your fire. The gargoyle must not be damaged.
Is this a plan you've neglected to mention?
We gotta get rid of him, or he's gonna hurt himself bad.
Okay, not our usual line of work, but let's see what we can do.
Hold it right there, soldier boy. You go anywhere near my bear, and I'll feed you to him piece by piece.
A roast?
Neato. Uh-oh, Mom's home. Just stay here, okay? I'll be back.
Oh, okay, well, I would, naturally.
I'm Dr. Lincoln Talbot, the zoo's chief veterinarian and animal behaviorist, and I look after my animals my way.
Everyone can use some backup.
You're right. Hold my coat.
He's so busy these days, even I have to book him in advance.
Del, you're cool if he hangs with me and my friends in Boca for the summer, right? He's afraid to ask you.
I am relocating to Izzy-free territory.
Time for Plan A.
Well, if we're talking about frequent flyer miles and passport stamps, it can only mean one horse. And there you see him all by his lonesome on the Arlington backstretch. It's Running Stag, who right now is 9-1 on the board. The question, as I've mentioned earlier, that all the handicappers have about Running Stag, can he run as well on the grass as he does on the dirt? We know how good he is on the main track. Well, that doesn't seem to bother his trainer, Philip Mitchell.
promise you, this guy is just as good on grass as he is on dirt. I have no compulsions on that. He ran a mega race in Hong Kong when he was second to Jim and Tonic. And if they'd have gone a little bit lively pace earlier on, there's no question Jim and Tonic would have had a job to catch us. And he only just jumped us in the last 50 yards. So, you know, this guy's as good on grass. It's a fallacy. It's just that he's, in the last really 2 years, he's really matured into a tough road warrior, which is what he's now nicknamed. And I think that I haven't wanted to run him on grass until this race. I've had this race picked out from the day I bought him. I thought that if ever he was going to make it, that's the one race I wanted to have a crack at when he was ready to have a go.
Oh, I feel simply awful. Must have slipped my mind.
Oh, that's a Tomo, the Metal Menace. He's not the hero, he's the villain. He's not like you. You're a good guy.
But hey, I think I know a way to ambush Buckskin Bill and get the horses back.
Really?
Honest? You do?
Sure. Bill's in town to rustle up horses, but I bet he'd also be tempted to grab himself a steer.
But Dad, where am I going to find a steer in this town?
Well, why don't you just leave that to me?
Hey, Angelica, looks like this'll be your big break if you win the audition.
If? As if.
Yo, what about Susie? She's got the best voice in the whole school.
Well, she's away. Her grandma's helping her with her hip replacement. So it's her tough break.
When I hired a guy named Sid Vicious, I assumed it would be a 30-year business relationship. I tell you to hire Tom Responsible. Slag off.
Dinner is served.
Your bath is ready, Hudson.
And away they go.
Because Furious D.
Where the hell did all these vampires come from?
They ain't vampires, man! They're zombies!
What?
They're zombies, Francis.
Yeah, whatever you say, Professor Monster.
Come on!
I can't stress enough how easy it was to win this prestigious race. And furthermore, Hollywood is leading our kids down a moral sewer. Gotta go!
I survive! It's my little eye!
We'll be ready.
just hate it when the guests drop by the house.
Shall we test the new security system, sir?
Why not? A little test never hurt anyone.
Let's go, Polly. And hold on to your holsters.
Go get me a trash bag.
Jimmy Neutron, you ruined my show! Strike that! Jimmy, you're a genius!
Get your ass over here! Burn it!
Ready?
Go!
Super special love arrow coming up.
You missed.
Juanita.
Cupid. Stu, you did it. You got Cupid and Juanita back together.
Yeah, I did. I saved Valentine's Day. I'm not such a klutz after all.
Oh, I know how it begins. Once upon a time... Jiminy, what does happen next?
Cutting edge, white kid.
Go back. We've gotta help.
What? That was Alma?
So you have got to come with me. My mom will wig out.
Yeah, sure thing. Just let me go check something first.
Hey now, Teddy. It's me, Link. That's right, you know me. I'm your friend, and I won't let anybody hurt you.
Easy, boy.
Giddy up.
Wait! Alma! Wait!
Why should I help you, Detweiler? Thanks to you, I'm gonna lose my job while you just dangle from the roof. Ow! Dangle from the roof? Hang on, TJ! I'm coming! Move it! Out of my way! Let me through!
What's happening, Principal Prickly?
Where is TJ?
He's around the corner. I need a ladder, quick!
Not right now, it isn't.
I think I'll go get the car started.
I've got it! The golden book of Amun-Ra is at Hermonaptra inside the statue of Horus. Take that, Bembridge scholars!
Whoa! Don't try that at home, kids!
There. You'll be better now.
I don't know about that.
If that's Cobra's new base, then that's where they're holding Hawk prisoner. We're bringing Hawk home.
I think we better have to. Listen.
Now we're gonna work together. On three, I'll pull up on one hand while you pull up with your other. You got that?
Yes, sir.
All right, just one more.
One, two, three. Principal Detweiler?
Thank you, sir.
What's that? This is for taking blood and tissue samples. But why?
Doc! Look out!
You saw me save you.
Everything's going to be okay, Harvey.
I can't believe it! You saved us. I never knew you were so above average.
Well, you get the idea anyway.
I could have handled it.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Congratulations on your victory. And now you will, of course, wish to have the losing team sacrifice to your glory.
Chucky, what'd you do that for?
Whenever you hear that song in Westerns, it means the bad guys are about to start a shootout!
Not again.
Look, Zekelcom!
Miguel.
Forget the sacrifices!
Miguel.
We don't want any sacrifices.
But all of the sacred writings say that you will devour the wicked and the unrighteous.
Well, I don't see anyone here who fits that description.
No, I am. It's a rule. They always beat up the older brother.
Well, as speaker for the gods, it would be my privilege to point them out.
The gods are speaking for themselves now. This city
And these people have no need for you anymore. There will be no sacrifices. Not now, not ever. Get out.
Just the right amount of electricity and some rubber cement. My monster will come.
Not bad for a day's work, eh?
No, not bad at all.
You did it, Tommy. Congratulations.
You guys did it.
But you're a great leader, and I knew you'd pull it off.
No, you didn't.
No, I didn't.
Just taking us? Oh, of course. I couldn't go without Michael and John.
Oh, I should like very much to cross swords with some real buccaneers.
Yes, and fight pirates, too.
Well, all right. But you gotta take orders.
Hi, Isa.
Me too.
Why, if it isn't my big brother.
There's some cold chicken in the icebox. You can have that and some carrots.
I'm way ahead of you, Mom.
Good. I'll make it up to you, okay?
Okay.
I love you, honey.
Me too.
And Hogarth? No scary movies, no late snacks, in bed by 8 o'clock. Got it?
Come on, Mom. It's me, remember?
Hey, I'm just following orders.
Jimmy! Ah! Awesome! This is even better than when we went in space. Everybody, lean to the left.
Well, we checked back in with ESPN.com and our poll results there as Chester House, well, poll order finished first. Chester House, Mandar, Mula Gula, Vienna Motto, Asadero, Running Stag, and Slickly the top seven. I'm not sure the poll is going to be quite in that order.
That would be quite some prognostication. We haven't talked a lot about breeding here, but just a quick mention. Chester House is the son of the now deceased Mr. Prospector, and what a big year for Mr. Prospector now that he's gone. Fusaichi Pegasus wins the Kentucky Derby. Chester House takes the Arlington Million.
Mandar, despite that long layoff, jumps back up there and finishes in second place.
And you've got the horse coming out of the Eddie Reed, Chester House winning the Million. The horse that skipped the Eddie Reed, Mandar, finishing second, but I don't know how much that told you necessarily given all the traffic problems we saw. There's the poll.
There's the poll. Mandar with 23% of the vote, and you can see Chester House there, third place with our online handicappers, just getting 17% of the vote. Not too bad.
All you had to do was take the top three and box them in the exacta. That's it.
You could make some money.
Thanks.
Well, I love this time of year when things really start getting intense. We start narrowing things in, and we see who are the real players now as the races get bigger and more important as the year goes on. Certainly, we'll look forward to a rematch of Mandar and Chester House. Yeah. And Jostle today in the Alabama certainly declared herself the leader of the three-year-old filly division.
That division seems to have the most focus, doesn't it, right now?
Well, we have to hear from Surfside. I mean, it's not over by any means, but that was a very overwhelming performance today.
But every other division seems wide open at this point, and usually by now you get a little bit of an idea, don't you?
Well, things is, we've got a long way to go until the Breeders' Cup.
Okay. Jeff?
And Bobby Franklin, not bad for him. He seemed a little bit disappointed, but he did run second in the Beverly D and followed that up with a win in the Arlington Million.
Winning those $2 million races can do a lot for a man's spirit, you know, and running second for a $500,000 is not too bad either.
The tracking monitor I shot her with is working. Fox has left the building.
So much for doing things the easy way.
According to the monitor, her metabolism is operating at a phenomenally accelerated rate. If this keeps up, her system will burn out before morning. She'll die.
Incredible. If I'd known the Eye of Odin had that kind of power, I'd never have just given it away. Well, spilled milk. Let's move on to Plan B.
Fight the terror within. When freedom cries out for a hero, his only
No.